Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. This is another session on arithmetic progression. So we are going to discuss few questions related to arithmetic progression on the basis of the formula what we have discussed in the last class. In last class we have discussed about the arithmetic progression and its sum of n terms of NIP. So today we are going to discuss some more questions related to that formula and how it can be used. So let me write some questions and also the solutions thereafter. First question is, sum of first n terms of NAP is n, and sum of first m terms of that AP is n. Find its sum of m plus n terms. Find sum of first m plus n terms. This is the question. So we have to discuss this question. In this question, we can write here, let A be the first term. Let A be the first term. Be the first term. And D be the common difference. D be the common difference. Common difference. D be the common difference. So sum of first m terms is n. This employ m by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, that is equal to m. This is the question 1. Also sum of first n term is m. This employ sum of first m terms is n, and n, this is n, and sum of first n terms is m. So n by 2 into 2a plus m terms, so m minus 1, right? Sum of m terms, so m minus 1, sum of n terms, so n minus 1 is equal to m. This is the second equation. Now we can find the difference of these two, and we can also calculate the value of m and n, and also, sorry, we can calculate the value of a and d. So here we can write in more simplification, am and an, 2 cancel. So here it will be am and an. If I can subtract first minus 2, then am minus an will come like an minus n plus m by 2 into m minus 1 plus n by 2 into n minus 1, and this is d is equal to n minus m. Again, I can write am minus n plus, this is d by 2 into 2, I can take common. That will be m square minus n square from here. M square minus n square minus m, and here it will be minus n, and that will be n minus m, or that can be also written like minus m minus n. If I can take m minus n common, if I can take m minus n, then it will be m plus n. Here it will be m plus n and m minus n. So what will happen? If since I have given the sign of negative, first minus second, then therefore what will happen? Sorry, this for this lack of coordination. Here m square minus n square. You know how? This is m into m. It will come m square, and m square minus m, that minus m written here. Here n into n, n square, and n into minus 1 is minus n, and due to this negative sign it would be plus n. But when we take negative sign common, then sign inside that will change. Now m minus n I can take common in the whole. What will happen? A plus b by 2, a plus b by 2 into, what is left here? M plus n, and what is left there? Minus 1 is equal to minus of m minus n. M minus n cancels out, And what is left here? A plus B by 2 into M plus N minus 1 is equal to minus 1. This is what? 2A plus M plus N minus 1 into D whole divided by 2 is equal to minus 1. Now we have to find the sum of, also we have to find sum of M plus N terms. M plus N terms. This is what we have to find out. So sum of M plus N terms can be written as M plus N by 2 into 2A plus M plus N minus 1 into D. Right? So that will be. So 2A plus N minus 1 into D can be written as minus 2. Or we can write it M plus N, and this 2 is divided by 2, and the whole thing can be written minus 1. So minus 1 is minus of M plus N, and that will be answer of this question. Let me discuss this question once again, and this is very good question, very important question. Sum of first n terms of an AP is m. Sum of first n terms is equal to n. Then we have to find sum of m plus n terms. This is a well-known question, everybody can do this. M plus n terms, if A be the first term and B be the common difference. A be the first term and B be the common difference. Then sum of first m terms is n. According to the formula, we can write m by 2, 2a plus a minus 1 to d is equal to n. Sum of n terms, so n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 to d is equal to m. This is also given. These are two equations. You can make it separate by multiplying this. So what will happen? If you multiply this by this, then 2, 2 cancel, m will left. Similarly here, n will left. So m minus an will be a common m minus n. Now this term multiply by this one also. So what will happen? M into m minus 1 into d by 2. So if I would have taken d by 2 common, then m into m minus 1, which will be m square minus n. And similarly that will be n square minus n. But due to negative sign, the sign inside that will be changed. But whenever we took negative sign again common, it will be minus. A square minus B square can be written as A minus B, A plus B. So A minus B I can take common. So what will left here? A plus B, that is M plus N. Here M plus N. So M plus N, and this thing I have taken common, so 1 minus 1 will left. Now here minus sign I have taken common, so M minus N left. You can cancel M minus N into M minus N. That can be cancelled. M minus N cancel with M minus N. And here A will left. Here D by 2 will left. M minus N has been taken common completely. So here M plus N is left. Here minus 1 is left. And that is equal to minus 1. So this is what left. If I took LCM, 2A plus B into M minus plus N minus 1 into D, that will be minus 1. So this complete value is minus 1, and here this is the complete whole value is there. So we can put it minus 1, so minus of m plus n, and that will be answer of this question. So hopefully you got this. Now let me write another question. One very popular question which is usually come in examination. Sum of, question number 2, sum of first p terms, p, q and r terms of an AP are A, B, C respectively. A, B, C respectively. Prove that A by P into Q minus R plus B by Q into R minus P plus C by R into P minus Q is equal to 0. That's the question. Right? So what to do and how to solve this question? If I can write this, that's sum of summation. Let me write summation first. Sum of first P terms is A. A is already mentioned, so we can take it like, let A be the first term A will be the first term, capital A, because small a already has been used. And D is the common difference. D is common difference. So sum of first P terms is A. This employ P by 2. 2A plus P minus 1 into D, and that is equal to A. So I can write it. If P will divide this side, A by P is equal to what? A by P is equal to this employee. If I multiply 2 inside, then 2A by 2 will be A plus P minus 1 into D by 2, and P divide this side. So what will happen? A by P. This is one. Similarly, we know QH term, similarly, sum of first Q terms is B. This employee A plus Q minus 1 into D by 2 is equal to B by Q will come. And R, sum of first R term is C, that will come up like R minus 1 into D by 2 is equal to C by R. These three terms can be derived by using the fact A by P, B by Q, C by R. Why I did this? Because we want A by P, B by Q and C by R. Now, we can proceed from the question. Now, we can write this. Since A by P into Q minus R, B by Q into R minus P, C by R into P minus Q is equal to what? In place of A by P, I can write all these terms A plus P minus 1 into D. So A plus P minus 1 into D into Q minus R. Similarly, A plus Q minus 1 into D into R minus P. And also, C by R is A plus R minus 1 into D into P minus Q, and that we have to calculate, that is equal to 0. Think about that. What is coming? A into this Q minus R will multiply with A. This R minus P multiply with A. This P minus Q also multiply with A. So A has multiplied Q minus R, R minus P, P minus Q. So if I can take A common, then what is left? A into Q minus R, so Q minus R, plus A into R minus P, in which R has been, A has been taken common, so R minus P, A into P minus Q, so if A can be taken common, then what is left? P minus Q. Got this? Plus, this multiply by this also. In that case, P minus 1 multiply by Q minus R into D. Here, Q minus 1 into R minus P into D. Here P minus Q into R minus 1 into T. So T is common everywhere. We can take D as a common. So what is left? P minus R 1 into Q minus R plus Q minus 1 into R minus P plus R minus 1 into P minus Q, and outside whole, what is common? D. D is common in all. So I can take D common. Now, you will find this, here Q is positive, Q is negative, P is positive, P is negative, R is positive, R is negative, so A into 0 plus D into, what will happen, try to think, PQ is positive here, if I multiply, and PQ is negative here, right, R is positive here, and R is negative here, got this? Similarly, every term is positive once and negative other times. R is positive, R is negative. Similarly, here what is that? PR is positive and here PR is negative. So, we can have every term will be once positive and one negative. That will be vanished. So, A into 0 plus D into 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. And this is what RH is, that we have to prove. You can write separately, it will be slightly lengthier, that first you multiply with A, then multiply with D. This is similarly R minus P into A, R minus P into this, P minus Q into A, P minus Q into R minus 1. Then you can take separately A common and D common, you will be able to get it. But overall, the things will come same and you will be able to find the answer, there is a 0. Similar type of question that can be also possible in for nth term. Let me write that question. Nth term. Instead of sum, if it is written like, question like, if pth, qth and rth term of an AP, question is third. If pth, qth and rth terms of an AP are ABC respectively, prove that A into B minus C plus A into Q minus R plus B into R minus P plus C into P minus Q is equal to 0. That can be also one result. The second result can be P into B minus C, Q into C minus A plus R into A minus B, that is also 0. That is also possible. Similar like question, but here instead of sum of n terms, this is Pth, Qth and Rth terms are given. So to solve such question, we need to write nth term of the equation. We have to deal with nth term. And everybody know what is nth term of an AP? Nth term of an AP, nth term is, do you remember that? What is nth term? Do you remember? Yes? Tell me. What is the answer? A plus n minus 1 into d, right? A plus n minus 1 into d. This is the tn term. Nth term, that is, tn is equal to nth term, that is a plus n minus 1 into d. So here, pth term is given, pth term is given a, qth term is given b, and rth term is given c. So I can write here, pth term is a, this employee, here I can take again, a is the capital A can be taken as the first term, a plus p minus 1 into d, or even a small d can be also taken, there is no problem. And what is that? A. Why I have taken separate A? Because the small a has been used already. Qth term is D. This employee A plus Q minus 1 into D is equal to B. Rth term is C. That can be written as A plus R minus 1 into D is equal to C. Now, what? We have to prove A into Q minus R plus B into R minus P plus C into P minus Q. So putting the value of, now I can write, let me write here. Now A into Q minus R plus B into R minus P plus C into P minus Q. A is what? A is A plus P minus 1 into D is A, and that is Q minus R. Plus B is A plus Q minus 1 into D, and that is R minus P. And third one is A plus R minus 1 into D into P minus Q. That I can write. I have placed the value of A from here, B and C. Respective places, I have put the value of A, B and C. Now what will come? A into Q minus R again in the similar situation. A into Q minus R plus P minus 1 into Q minus R into D plus A into R minus P plus Q minus 1 into R minus P into D plus A into P minus Q plus R minus 1 into P minus Q into D. So that will come. Now if I take A common from here, A common from here, A common from here, so what is left then? A into Q minus R plus R minus P plus P minus Q. Also if I took D common, then what is left? If I took D common, then inside that P minus 1 into Q minus R plus Q minus 1 into R minus P plus R minus 1 into P minus Q, right? That will left. That is left. Now R and R cancel, P and P cancel, Q and Q cancel. So what is left? A into 0 plus B into. Again you can observe this. The same thing what we did in the last question. PQH positive and PQH negative. R is positive, here R is negative. Here PR is positive and there PR is negative. Every term will be similar, like somewhere positive, somewhere negative, and therefore what will come? 0. They will also vanish. So 0 finally. So first part of the question can be solved by using this, and you will be able to answer such question. What about the second part? For second part, we need to find the value of B minus C and C minus A, A minus B. How to find this? B minus C, if I consider this as three different equations, then B minus C I can obtain if I subtract second minus third, isn't it? Second minus third will give what? If I subtract second minus third, A, A cancel, Q minus R, minus 1 plus 1, that would be also cancelled, because after taking negative sign, sign will change, minus 1 minus, minus 1 will be cancelled. So Q minus R into D will come. Q minus R into D is B minus C. B minus C can come, C minus A can come if 3 minus 1, third minus 1, then it will come R minus P into D is equal to C minus 1. And first minus second, then what will come? First minus second, if I can do that, P minus Q into D is equal to A minus P. Now, the given question is P into B minus C plus Q into C minus A plus R into A minus B is equal to what? So if I place the value of B minus C, what will happen? P into Q minus R into D. Q into C minus A is R minus P into D. And A minus B is what? Nothing else but P minus R into P minus Q into D. If I could take D common, then what is left? P into Q minus R, Q into R minus P, and R into P minus Q. This is a cyclic expression, always turn like this. Remember this fact, if this is a P, Q, R, and one of them multiply by difference of other two will be a cyclic expression, and value of that is always 0. How? PQ is positive, here PQ is negative. Here PR is negative, here PR is what? PR is positive. Similarly, everywhere, here QR is negative and there QR is positive. So every term is positive once and negative second time, and therefore they are vanishing. It will be 0, and therefore answer is 0. So two ways to write this question. There are two different patterns in which the question has been written, and you will be able to answer the such questions by using this fact. I hope you got this. How to deal with such question? These are very, very important question which you should know, and that is why these questions play a very important role. Often it is asked in competitive examination, so you must aware about the fact. Okay? Thank you. Now let me write another question. Question is, this type of question can be also come if the sum of three terms of an AP, sum of three terms of an AP is 18. Sum of three terms of an AP is 21, and their product is 315. Find the numbers. That can be also a question. So whenever such question is given, what to do? Three numbers of APR, we can assume A minus B, A plus D, and A. A and A plus D, like this. A minus D, if you add D, then this will come. If you add D, then this will come. These are the three consecutive terms of an AP. Suppose one has to find four consecutive terms of an AP. This is a concept, try to understand. Then what I can take? A minus 2D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 2D. Like this. 3D, A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 3D. Here the common difference is 2D. This minus this is 2D. This minus this is 2D. This minus this is 2D. This minus this. So we can write like this. If you have to suppose 5 terms, then you can write A minus D, A plus D, A minus D, 2D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 2D. Yeah. What is the difference? D. So sometimes here the difference is 2D. We will consider that. It can be also written in other form, that alpha plus beta, alpha minus 3 beta, alpha minus beta, alpha plus beta, alpha plus 3 beta, like that, so that you don't be confused with D, that why sometimes the difference can be taken D and why in this question difference is 2D. That is the difference. It can be anything. It may be twice, it may be once. So we can, this is a concept which we have to deal with. And on the basis of this concept, one can answer the question. So we can take it like this. Three terms are A minus D, A plus D. So their sum is A plus D is equal to 21. D cancel. 3A is equal to 21. A is equal to 7. And their product is 315. A plus D is equal to 315. So 7 minus D, 7, 7 plus D is equal to 315. That is 49 minus D square, because A minus B, A plus B, and that 7 can cancel this how many times? 45 times. So D square is equal to 49 minus 45, that is 4, and D is equal to plus minus 2. So D is plus minus 2. Once you put D is equal to 2, then numbers are, what is that? If D is equal to 2, numbers are, A is 7, D is 2. So A minus D, A is 7, 7 minus 2, that is 5. A, that is 7, and A plus D, that is 7 plus 2 is 9. So numbers are 5, 7, 9. And when you put A is equal to 7 and D is equal to minus 2, then A minus D will come 7 minus minus 2, that is 9. A, that is 7, and A plus D would be 7 minus 2, that is 5. So answer would be either 5, 7, 9 or 9, 7, 5. I hope you got it. Answer would be either 5, 7, 9 or 9, 7, 5. That will be the answer of this question. I hope you got it, right? So whenever you have to suppose three terms, you can take it like this. Because why these have been taken? Because whenever we find the sum, then D cancels and A can be obtained. Thank you very much. Thank you, and we will be seeing in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.